गेट रेडी फॉर द डिक्टेशन स्टार्ट. इन द रिजॉइंडर एफिडेविट फाइल्ड बाय द पिटिशनर अगेंस्ट द कंटेंशंस रेज्ड इन द रिट पिटिशन ही डिनाइड द एवरमेंट्स मेड इन द काउंटर एफिडेविट एंड स्टेटेड दैट नो डिमांड नोटिस वॉज गिवेन टू द पिटिशनर नॉर द अलॉटमेंट कैंसिलेशन ऑर्डर डेटेड 23/8/2006 was ever given to the petitioner and no such documents have been annexed with the counter affidavit and hence the cancellation order was not in the notice of the petitioner and is denied. Stop. The cancellation order was never served upon the petitioner, only a communication regarding the said order was given by respondent number 2 on the basis of which he immediately applied for recall of the cancellation order on 24/8/2006. Stop. Since respondents number 2 and 5 were not considering the recall of the cancellation order and was planning to take possession of the property of the petitioner and thus he had to file the writ petition. Stop. It is apparent that they delayed the decision on recall application deliberately and hence they cannot claim any extra charges from the petitioner except those provided in clause 11 of the broker. Stop. It is further submitted that there is no government order dated 20/11/1999 on record and in the broker there is no provision that once a allottee defaults in payment of installment, the casting guidelines of the government orders dated 20/11/1999 shall be applied to his case and the conditions given in para 11 of the broker has become redundant. Stop. Therefore, the petitioner cannot be compelled to pay charges beyond the scope and ambit of clause 11 of the broker. Stop. It is further contended that why the prevailing rate on 9/10/2006 was taken into consideration when clause 11 of the broker did not provide the same, which has not been explained by the respondents. Stop. It is further provided that according to clause 11 of the broker, if the highest bidder / auction purchaser wants restoration of the cancellation order within 1 month from its cancellation, then he is required to deposit the entire due amount with penal interest and 7% restoration charges of the value of the land and thereafter an order of restoration of his allotment order shall be passed and the remaining cost of the plot shall be payable as per the terms and conditions agreed earlier para. From the contentions raised in the accompanying affidavit to the writ petition, in the counter affidavit and rejoinder affidavit, the main controversy which arises in the present writ petition is whether the parties who have entered into an agreement as per contentions of the petitioner void annexure 2 and it is not denied by the respondents, whether the parties of the contract or agreement are bound by the terms of the agreement as they were on the date of the execution of agreement, that is 1/2/2005. Stop. Annexure 2 of the writ petition is the agreement executed between the parties. Stop. Admittedly, the agreement was executed in between Meerut Development Authority and the petitioner, a copy of which is annexed as Annexure 2 to the writ petition. Stop.